value on the reward that that is in those salawat, the reward. He said they will come even if they had to crawl like a baby. And then he said, وَلَقَدْ هَمَمْتُ أَنْ تُقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ. He said, I was about to have the salat established, and I will put someone to lead a man, to lead the Muslims in the salat. And I will go back with some men with me, carrying bundles of wood with them. And I will go to those men who do not attend Salat al-Jama'ah, and I will burn down their houses. I will burn down their houses. Subhanallah. Al-ulama, they say the reason he did not do it, because of the women and children. It shows you, ikhwan, the danger of this affair. The Prophet sallam, he would burn down the houses of those who lag behind and they don't come for Salat al-Jama'ah. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he said about this affair, he said, none of us will lag behind. None of us will lag behind and does not come to attend Salat al-Jama'ah. He said, except a hypocrite, munafiq, ma'lumun nifaq. He's known for his hypocrisy. Subhanallah. Look, and also in Mustadrak al-Hakim, this is an athar by Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, he said, when a man would not show up for Salat al-Fajr and Salat al-Isha, we would have a bad opinion about him. We would have a bad opinion about this man who does not come to the masjid for Salat al-Fajr and Isha. And subhanallah, the reward is tremendous. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من صلى العشاء في جماعة فكأنما قام نصف الليل ومن صلى الفجر في جماعة فكأنما قام الليل كله. Allahu Akbar. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, whoever performs Salat al-Isha in congregation, it's like he prayed half a night Qiyam al-Layl. Subhanallah. And whoever performs Salat al-Fajr in congregation, it's like he made the whole night Qiyam al-Layl. Look at the reward that the person gets. So the person who does not perform Salat, the congregation prayer in the masjid, this person is a sinner. There's no doubt about that. And a blind man, Abdullah ibn Maktoum radiallahu anhu, Sheikh al-Imam ibn Baz, he mentioned this in his fatwa about this affair. He said that this sahabi, he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, O Messenger of Allah, I am a blind man and I don't have a guide. I don't have somebody to guide me. And the Medina has all kind of creatures. You have snakes, you have vipers, you have all kind of creatures there, and I'm walking by myself. He said, do you hear the Adhan? He said, yes, I do. He said, فَأَجِبْ. He said, you respond to it, means you come to the masjid. Allahu Akbar. This is how the Sahaba radiallahu anhum used to come. And I want to share with you, brothers, this is a wake-up call for all of us. Wallahi. Al-Rabi' ibn Khutaym, one of the Imam of the Salaf. Al-Rabi' ibn Khutaym, rahimahullah ta'ala. Rabi ibn Khutaym, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested him with a disease. It's called al-falij. Al-falij is half paralysis. Can you believe that? His body is half paralyzed. Okay? Rabi ibn Khutaym, one time he heard the Adhan. He told his son, take me to the masjid. And he had guests with him. They said, Ya Aba al-Mundir, you are one of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made an excuse for you. ليس على المريض حرج. Allah said that in the Quran. There is nothing upon al-marid, the sick person. You have an excuse. So he said what he said. He said, يعز على نفسي أن أسمع داعي الله ولا أجيبه. He said, it is very hard upon my soul to hear أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله, and I don't respond to it. They had to drag him to the masjid. With the Salaf, ikhwan, brothers and sisters. These are the Salaf. This upon the brothers, the sisters, alhamdulillah, they're not included in our speech. But the brothers, they have to come to the masjid. There's no excuse for anyone. If the Sahaba could walk, wallahi, I read one of the biographies of one of the Salaf. He was in the agony of death. He was going through the agony of death. And the Adhan of Maghrib was called out. He said, take me to the Masjid. Subhanallah. They took him to the Masjid. He prayed with the Imam, one rak'ah, and he passed away in the Salat. These are the Salaf. These are the Salaf, Ya Ikhwan. These are the Salaf. And there are many examples about the Salaf. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, he said for 50 years, I believe he said 40 or 50 years, he said whenever the Mu'addin said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, I am inside the Masjid. And one of the Imam, I think Ibrahim al-Taymi, he said, I have never seen the back of a man. What does that mean? He never prayed in the second row or the third row. He's always in the front. He never seen the back of a man. These are the Salaf. Rahimahum Allah Ta'ala. Naam. Waddan. Waiyak, waiyak. Naam. To join them in their khuruj? You tell him, Akhi, I cannot go with you. Because this jama'ah that you are involved with them, they are people of innovation. And I have proofs and evidence. There is the fatawa. You want the fatawa of Sheikh bin Baz? Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah, before he died, about, I believe, 2 years or two, about 2 years before he passed away. That way, jama'ah tabligh cannot confuse you. Sheikh, rahimahullah, he said this fatwa 2 years before he passed away in the city of Ta'if. The person asked Sheikh Rahimahullah, is Jama'at al-Ikhwan al-Muslimin, the Muslim Brotherhood, Ikna Isna, okay? And because they play games with names, okay. Sometimes they call themselves something else. But anyway, they are the same people. The same people. He asked him, Jama'at al-Ikhwan al-Muslimin, the Muslim Brotherhood, and the Tablighi Jama'at, are they from the 72 deviant sects? He said, yes, they are. And so the person, he wanted to make sure that the Sheikh understood him correctly. He said, ya Sheikh, Jama'at al-Ikhwan al-Muslimin wa al-Tabligh, are they from the 72 sect? He said, yes, they are, alone with al-Khawarij and al-Murji'ah and other than them. You see? So when you bring them this statement, you say, okay, Akhi, do you respect Samahat Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Ibaz? He say, is he going to say no? He's going to say, okay, Sheikh bin Baz is our Sheikh. Because, you know, he has an old fatwa. He has an old fatwa praising them before he came to know the reality, you know. So he praised them a long time ago. Now you tell him, listen, this is the last fatwa of the Sheikh before he passed away. This is what he said about you, about the Jama'ah. I want khair for you. I'm not going to go with you. Because this jama'ah is upon misguidance. I'm not going to take this journey with you. And I want khair for you. Read this fatawa of Sheikh bin Baz. Sheikh Muhammad Nasir Din al-Albani, when he was asked about them, he said, Sufiya Asriya, modern Sufis. That's what he said about them. And Sheikh Abdullah bin Ghadiyan also has a fatwa. Muhammad bin Ibrahim, Ali Sheikh, has a fatwa about Salih al-Haydan. As a fatwa about them. And also Sheikh Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhali has fatwa about Jama'at al-Tabligh. Ubaid al-Jabiri, Sheikh Ubaid ibn Abdullah al-Jabiri. And many, many scholars, walhamdulillah, they have clarified the reality of this deviant sect, Jama'at al-Tabligh. Aynam. Aynam. Barakallah fiqh. That's it. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all beneficial knowledge and righteous action. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wa fiikum barakallahu. That's what makes it so important to do it. There's a punishment attached to it.
That's a punishment.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
Since we are traveling, inshallah, we're going to shorten the salat for those who are traveling with us. And you continue, inshallah, after we finish, inshallah. Barakallahu feek, Mr. Allahu Akbar. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdika. La ilaha illa anta. A'udhu billahi. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Malik yawm al-deen. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. والعاديات ذبحا فالموريات قدحا فالمغيرات صبحا فأترن به نقعا فوسطن به جمعا إن الإنسان لربه لكنود وإنه على ذلك لشهيد وإنه لحب الخير لشديد أفلا يعلم إذا بعثر ما في القبور وحصل ما في الصدور إن ربهم بهم يومئذ لخبير. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. ربنا لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. القارعة ما القارعة وما أدراك ما القارعة يوم يكون الناس كالفراش المبثوث وتكون الجبال كالعهن المنفوش فأما من ثقلت موازينه فهو في عيشة راضية وأما من خفت موازينه فأمه